In this video, I am going to discuss about the body fluids and circulation. We know that all living cells require constant supply of nutrients, oxygen, and other essential substances. Also, the waste or harmful substances produced need to be removed continuously for the healthy functioning of tissues. It is therefore essential to have efficient mechanisms for the movement of these substances to the cells and from the cells. Simple organisms like sponges and cylindrates circulate water present in their surroundings through their body cavities to facilitate the body cells to exchange these substances. On the other hand, in more complex organisms, special fluids are present within their bodies for the transportation of such materials. In most of the higher organisms, including humans, blood is the most commonly used body fluid for this purpose. Another body fluid, that is lymph, is also helps in the transport of certain substances. So, it is important to know about the composition and properties of blood and lymph, and also the mechanism of blood circulation. So let's start with the blood. Blood is a specialized connective tissue consisting of a fluid matrix, plasma, and a cellular portion called formed elements. The plasma constitutes approximately 55% of the blood, and formed elements account for remaining 45%. So now, plasma. Plasma is a straw-colored viscous fluid forming matrix of the blood. It is a ground substance. It is means what? Matrix. Matrix is the ground substance of a tissue or a non-living substance occupying the space between cells. Now, the composition of plasma. So, the first is water. 90 to 92% of plasma is water. Next is proteins. Proteins constitute about 6 to 8% of plasma. Fibrinogens, globulins, and albumins are the major plasma proteins. Fibrinogen is an important clotting factor produced by the liver. Globulins are primarily involved in the defense mechanism of the body. They are grouped into three subtypes: alpha globulins, beta globulins, and gamma globulins. Gamma globulins are antibodies which function in immune response of the body. Next is albumins. Albumins help in osmotic balance. They maintain the osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is needed to draw water from the surrounding tissue fluid into the capillaries. And this action is needed to maintain blood volume and pressure. Plasma contains small amounts of minerals like sodium, calcium, magnesium, bicarbonates, etc. Plasma without the clotting protein is called serum. Next is formed elements. The formed elements include erythrocytes, leukocytes, and thrombocytes. Erythrocytes means red blood cells, leukocytes means white blood cells, and thrombocytes means platelets. So, let's start with the erythrocytes. The erythrocytes are the most abundant of all cells in the blood. A healthy adult man on an average has 5 million to 5.5 million of RBCs per cubic meter millimeter of blood. In most of the mammals, RBCs are biconcave in shape and are without nucleus. However, in camel and llama, they are oval, but in that also nucleus is absent. Their unique shape relates to their function, and the main function is what? Transporting oxygen. As the red blood cells lack nucleus and other cell organelles, so it helps in providing more space for hemoglobin. Due to the absence of mitochondria, they respire anaerobically, and so they don't use up any of the oxygen they carry. Red blood cells also contain the enzyme carbonic anhydrase, which plays a role in carbon dioxide transport. So if the question is which enzyme present in the blood helps in the transport of carbon dioxide, then the answer will be what? Carbonic anhydrase. Now, the quantity of hemoglobin in RBCs. A healthy individual has 12 to 16 grams of hemoglobin in every 100 ml of blood. Iron is present in hemoglobin, and the formation of RBCs is known as erythropoiesis. It occurs in the red bone marrow in adults. Functions. Hemoglobin of erythrocytes play a significant role in transport of respiratory gases. Hemoglobin combines readily with oxygen and forms oxyhemoglobin. Oxyhemoglobin readily gives up its oxygen in the tissues, where it is used for the breakdown or oxidation of food. The second function is RBCs also transport carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs. Carbon dioxide is carried by hemoglobin as carbaminohemoglobin. Now, the formation of blood is called hemopoiesis. You are well familiar with the term anemia. So what is anemia? Anemia refers to any condition in which there is an abnormally low hemoglobin concentration and or red blood cell count. The most common type is iron deficiency anemia, caused by the deficiency of iron, which is an essential component of the hemoglobin molecule. Next type of anemia is pernicious anemia. It is an inadequate amount of vitamin B12 in the body, which is needed for red blood cell maturation. Yeah? Now, next is the leukocytes. Leukocytes or WBC are colorless due to the lack of hemoglobin. So in RBC, hemoglobin is present, whereas in WBC, hemoglobin is absent. Leukocytes are much lesser in number as compared to erythrocytes, which averages 6,000 to 8,000 per cubic millimeter of blood. So this is the second difference between the RBCs and WBCs. Leukocytes possesses nuclei and other cell organelle and can move in an amoeboid fashion. So again, in RBC nucleus is absent, whereas in WBC nucleus is present. This is the third difference. Due to this ability, leukocytes can squeeze through pores in capillary wall and move to a site of infection. This movement is called as what? Diapedesis. Clear? This is called as what? Diapedesis. Okay. So what is diapedesis? You can write like this. The movement of leukocytes through capillary walls to the site of infection is known as diapedesis. Clear? Now, type of leukocytes. So the first is leukocytes. Leukocytes are most invisible under the microscope unless they are stained. So they are classified according to their staining properties. Clear? So there are two types of leukocytes. First is agranulocyte and the second one is granulocyte. क्लियर। सो ल्यूकोसाइट्स कंटेनिंग ग्रेन्यूल्स इन देयर साइटोप्लाज्म आर कॉल्ड ग्रेन्यूलर ल्यूकोसाइट्स और ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स एंड दोज विदाउट क्लियरली विजिबल ग्रेन्यूल्स आर कॉल्ड अ ग्रेन्यूलर ल्यूकोसाइट्स और अ ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स। सो लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द अ ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स। देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ अ ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स, लिम्फोसाइट्स एंड मोनोसाइट्स। लिम्फोसाइट्स आर यूजुअली द सेकेंड मोस्ट न्यूमरस टाइप ऑफ ल्यूकोसाइट्स। दे आर स्मॉल सेल्स विथ राउंड न्यूक्लियाई एंड लिटिल साइटोप्लाज्म। दे एग्जिस्ट इन टू मेजर फॉर्म्स, बी एंड टी लिम्फोसाइट्स, एंड आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेस ऑफ द बॉडी। सेकेंड इज मोनोसाइट्स। दे आर द लार्जेस्ट ल्यूकोसाइट्स एंड आर समवॉट अमीबॉइड इन शेप। दे हैव किडनी और हॉर्स शू शेप्ड न्यूक्लियाई। दे स्पेंड अबाउट 30-40 आवर्स इन द ब्लड एंड देन एंटर द टिश्यू वेयर दे बिकेम मैक्रोफेजेस। मैक्रोफेजेस आर फैगोसाइटिक इन नेचर एंड इनगल्फ बैक्टीरिया एंड अदर सेल्यूलर डेब्रीज। ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स। ग्रेन्यूलोसाइट्स आर ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स। फर्स्ट इओसिनोफिल्स। इओसिनोफिल्स हैव न्यूक्लियस विथ टू लोब्स। दे हैव कोर्स ग्रेन्यूल्स विच कंटेन हाइड्रोलिटिक एंजाइम्स एंड पेरोक्सीडेजेस। द इओसिनोफिल्स हैव एंटी हिस्टामिनिक प्रॉपर्टीज। दे रेजिस्ट इन्फेक्शन एंड आर ऑल्सो एसोसिएटेड विथ एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस। द नंबर ऑफ इओसिनोफिल्स इंक्रीजेज ड्यूरिंग एलर्जिक कंडीशन सच एज एस्थमा एंड हे फीवर। दे ऑल्सो हेल्प इन डिजॉल्विंग ब्लड क्लॉट। दे सीम टू प्ले अ पार्ट इन द इम्यून सिस्टम। दे हैव सम सिमिलरिटीज टू लाइजोसोम्स एंड लाइजोसोम्स आर वॉट। Lysosomes are also called as suicidal bag. Eosinophils can attach themselves to parasitic forms and cause their destruction by liberating lysosomal enzymes on their surfaces. Second is basophils. They are least abundant of the total WBCs. In these cells, the nucleus is generally three-lobed. Clear? So in eosinophils it is two lobed and in basophils it is three lobed. The cells secrete serotonin and heparin and histamine. Clear? Then the third is neutrophils. They are the most abundant cells of the total WBCs. They are phagocytic in nature. Phagocytic in nature means what? They engulf, they digest the foreign bodies or we can say the bacteria. They commonly squeeze between the cells of the capillary walls and wander through the intercellular spaces. From here, they move to infected areas of the body. They engulf and digest diseases causing bacteria. Now the formation of leukocytes. Formation of leukocytes is called leukopoiesis. It takes place in the bone marrow. B lymphocytes mature in bone marrow itself, but T lymphocytes mature in thymus. Clear? So that is why the name is given what? T lymphocytes means mature in thymus. Like this you can learn also. B lymphocytes means mature where? In bone marrow. Clear? Now the lifespan. Once released from the bone marrow, the life of granulocytes is normally 4-8 hours when circulating in the blood and about 4-5 days in the tissues. The monocytes have lifespan of 10-20 hours, whereas the lymphocytes have lifespans of few days or months or even years. Leukocytosis. Rise in the WBC count is called as leukocytosis. It usually occurs at the site of infection. Third is thrombocytes. Thrombocytes are the smallest of the formed elements, and blood normally contains 150,000 to 350,000 platelets per cubic millimeter of blood. Thrombocytes are cell fragments rather than true cells. They are rounded or oval disc-like bodies. They lack nuclei and contain a few cell organelles and secretory granules in them. Formation, they are produced from special cells in the bone marrow called megakaryocytes. Normal lifespan of blood platelets is about a week. They are destroyed in the spleen and liver. They play an important role in blood clotting. Platelets can release a variety of substances, most of which are involved in coagulation of blood. They constitute most of the mass of the clot and activate the clotting factors in plasma that results in formation of threads of fibrin. A reduction in the number of platelets is called thrombocytopenia, which leads to excessive loss of blood from the body. Purpura is a group of bleeding disease due to thrombocytopenia. Clear? And what is thrombocytopenia? A reduction in the number of platelets is called as what? Thrombocytopenia.
Now the question time. Question number 1. Carbonic anhydrase is playing an important role in transport of carbon dioxide in, and the options are number 1 leukocytes, number 2 thrombocytes, number 3 erythrocytes, number 4 platelets, and the answer is erythrocytes. Now question number 2. DASH is known as the graveyard of RBCs, and the options are number 1 liver, number 2 spleen, number 3 pancreas, and number 4 bone marrow, and the answer is spleen. Yes, correct. And the answer is spleen. Next, the metal present in hemoglobin is number 1 magnesium, number 2 sodium, number 3 iron, number 4 copper, and the answer is iron. Now next question, the lifespan of erythrocytes in humans is about, option number 1 120 days, 2 150 days, third option 190 days, and fourth option 180 days, and the correct answer is 120 days. Clear? Now next, an anti-clotting factor heparin is produced by number 1 option eosinophils, second option neutrophils, third option basophils, fourth option monocytes, and the answer is basophils. Now next question, histamines and serotonin are secreted by option number 1 agranulocytes, option number 2 erythrocytes, option number 3 thrombocytes, and option number 4 basophils, and the correct answer is basophils. Now next question, the most abundant WBCs are option 1 monocytes, option 2 lymphocytes, option 3 neutrophils, option 4 eosinophils, and the correct option is neutrophils. Now next question, the least abundant of the total WBCs are number 1 monocytes, number 2 basophils, number 3 eosinophils, number 4 neutrophils, and the correct answer is basophils. Next question, DASH play an important role in blood clotting. Number 1 erythrocytes, number 2, leukocytes, number 3, thrombocytes, number 4, all of these. And the correct option is thrombocytes. Next, special cells in the bone marrow that produce thrombocytes are number 1 option, B cells, number 2 option, T cells, number 3, megakaryocytes, number 4, monocytes. And the correct option is B cells. Okay? So all the best for your preparation.
Thank you very much. Have a nice day.